When was the last time you Googled medical information? Wait a minute. Don't you find it offensive to all the other search engines that whenever we search for something online, we always call it Googling? Anyways, back to the topic. So when you search for medical information online, likely on Google, how do you know what you're looking at is good quality information? We do this every day, at least the majority of Americans do. But do you actually know that the information you're looking at is something that you can believe and something that you should follow? Let's talk about how you can find good quality medical information on the internet. Most of you are probably going to start with a Google search or Bing or one of the other many search engines. And if you're like the majority of Americans, you're going to click on the first link. But that first link may not contain the best information. So how do you know, or how do you find the best information? Well, the first thing that you might want to do is actually skip Google and go straight to several sources. Some of these examples would be like WebMD, Mayo Clinic, Cleveland Clinic, Johns Hopkins Medicine, Stanford Medicine. There's a bunch of them out there that offer a breadth of information on general medical topics and give you good quality advice that you can feel pretty safe following without having to worry about the quality of the content. But if you are going to go back to that Google search, let's talk about what you can look for when you click on that first link. So the first thing you're going to want to look for is, did it come from a quality source? So the websites that I just mentioned, Mayo, Cleveland Clinic, WebMD, those are all great places, but there's a ton more out there besides just those few. Generally speaking, what you're going to want to look for is either a government agency, and those websites are going to end in .gov. Examples of those are going to be the CDC, NIH, National Library of Medicine. Again, there's several different sites you can go to that's going to have good quality information. Other sites you're going to look for are going to be your educational universities, such as a Stanford Health, a Mayo Clinic, Johns Hopkins, etc. Those are going to be pretty well-known household names that you're probably going to recognize pretty quickly. And in general, they're going to float to the top of your Google searches. You can also trust, in general, information that comes from several of the United States or even international medical societies. Examples of these are going to be like familydoctor.org, which is put on by the American Academy of Family Physicians. There's also going to be other societies associated with multiple different specialties such as orthopedics, endocrinology, cardiology. And then another good source of information is also going to be places like the American Diabetes Association, American Heart Association. Again, most of those are going to be well-known household names. Most of the time when you're going to start running into questionable sites or questionable information is when you start getting on down the list on your Google search and you start getting into some more personal physician websites, general websites, places where you can't readily identify the source of the information. And you're going to want to be careful with those because unfortunately on the internet, anybody can set up a website, go out there, call themselves doctor, and make themselves look like an authority on the subject. They could have a fancy website with lots of colors and graphics, and their text may sound overly convincing. But if you can't verify the identity of the person, or you can't verify that they have an editorial board that's reviewed the information, or frankly, if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. Another big warning sign is if they're trying to sell you something. Most physicians, most medical professionals, they're putting this information out there for your benefit, not necessarily trying to sell you on anything. So if it sounds too good to be true, or it looks like they're trying to sell you something, I would probably question the source and maybe go on to one of those sources that I mentioned before. Another set of websites that you might want to look into are going to be some of your clinical trials websites. Clinicaltrials.gov is an excellent website to go to if you're looking for information on clinical trials or how you can participate in clinical trials. Another common topic that's searched for on the internet is going to be information on medications. Again, if you're going for a general Google search, that's fine. But make sure, again, that you're getting your information from a site that can be considered a good quality site. A lot of your national drugstore chains are going to have information on medications, CVS, Walgreens, etc. GoodRx is another good information site, not only for names and doses of medications, but also, frankly, prices of medications, which is ever important. Another good general website for medication information is going to be one called drugs.com. You can search for just about any medication on this site that you can think of and find good quality information on it. And then, of course, there's another governmental website on medications as well. That's going to be the FDA.gov website. Here you can find information on recalls, warnings on specific drugs. And again, a lot of your general websites like WebMD, even some of the well-known name brand sites like Mayo, Cleveland Clinic are going to have information on drugs as well. And if you can't remember all of the websites that I've listed in this video, I'll put some of them in the description below, but you can also find most of these linked from my personal website, lewiskrennmd.com. And from there, you can be sure that you're linking out to websites that I have personally reviewed and consider to be great resources for finding medical information online. Okay, that's all that I have for you today. I hope that you find this video helpful. I hope it helps you find good quality information. And remember, anytime you find anything online, make sure to review it with your personal physician before you act upon it so you can make sure that you're being as safe as possible. And all right, if you are enjoying these videos and would like to see more of them, please leave me some comments down below. Remember to subscribe and like this video, and be safe out there.